to our festival service of nine lessons and carols, our carol service for churches of St Francis and Emmanuel. And as such, the service will be recorded and shown on our joint YouTube channel, Friendly Churches. So if you're watching and joining in at home, you're very welcome. Just a couple of notices before the start of the service. You'll see that from the front cover of the order of service, we're not actually in St Francis Penisley, but as two joint churches, we are still part of the St Francis and Emmanuel together. But the numbers of the carols relate to a different hymn book. We're using the carol sheet, so the numbers that are printed on the order of service are not the actual order. Numbers of the carols, just to confuse you even further. So I'm going to announce the numbers of the carols when we get to them. So ignore the number written on there and listen to the one I say. But if I get it wrong, then that's my fault. Obviously, we will ask you to keep masks on if you are possibly able to do that even during the singing. And obviously so that we can sing all the carols but still keep things as simple as possible. We're going to, first of all, when the carol's announced, we're going to listen to the organ playing the tune through once, so please stay seated. And then once the tune has been completely played through, please stand and sing the first verse and the last verse of the carol. First verse and the last verse of each carol on the back of the carol sheet. So we're going to have our first carol now, once in Royal David City, which is number 9 on the hymn sheet. Please stay seated for the first Messiah, Jesus coming into the world, but people looking forward to it. As we are happy, preparing for Christmas, and as we do in the church through Advent, start off with a promise, a kind of tiny flicker of light, which slowly builds up and builds up until it becomes the miracle of the incarnation, where God himself enters his own creation. And then that story continues, and it continues, and at Easter we then realise the fulfilment of that, where Jesus is there for us fully. So I'm going to start with some prayers, and then readings will start. I'm going to ask readers, please, read through the lectern, so the microphone will pick up your voice, and we'll hear this mystery of the incarnation gradually being unfolded as we share these lovely carols. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ be with thee. Beloved in Christ, be it this Christmas tide our care and delight to prepare ourselves to hear again the message of the angels. In heart and mind, go even unto Bethlehem, and see this thing which is come to pass, and with the Magi adore the child lying in his mother's arms. Let us read and mark in Holy Scripture the tale of the loving purposes of God, from the first days of our disobedience up to the glorious redemption brought us by this holy child. And let us make this chapel dedicated to his pure and lowly mother glad with our carols of praise. But first let us pray for the needs of his whole world, for peace and goodwill over all the earth, for unity and brotherhood within the church he came to build. And let us at this time remember in his name the poor and the helpless, the cold, the hungry and the oppressed, the sick in body and in mind, and then the poor, the lonely and the unloved, the aged and the little children, and all who know not the loving kindness of God. Lastly, let us remember before God all those who rejoice with us, but on another shore, and in a greater light, that multitude which no man can number, whose hope is in the Word made flesh, and with whom we forevermore are one. These prayers and praises let us humbly offer up to the throne of heaven in the words which Christ himself has taught us. We say together, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. The Almighty God now bless us with his grace. Christ, give us the joys of everlasting life, and unto the fellowship of the citizens above, may the King of Angels bring us all.
The first lesson, God tells simple Adam that he has lost the life of paradise and that his seed will bruise the serpent's head, Genesis chapter 3. And they heard the voice of the Lord walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And Adam and his wife hid themselves from the serpent, from the presence of the Lord God, amongst the trees of the garden. And the Lord God called unto Adam and said unto him, Where art thou? And he said, I heard thy voice in the garden, and I was afraid, because I was naked, and I hid myself. And he said, Who told thee that thou wast naked? Hast thou eaten of the tree whereof I commanded thee that thou shouldst not eat? And the man said, The woman who thou gavest to be with me, she gave me of the tree, and I did eat. And the Lord God said unto the woman, What is this that thou hast done? And the woman said, The serpent beguiled me, and I did eat. And the Lord God said unto the serpent, Because thou hast done this, thou art cursed above all cattle, and above every beast of the field. Upon thy belly shalt thou go, and dust shalt thou eat all the days of your life, and I will put enmity between thee and his heel. And unto Adam he said, because thou hast hearkened unto the voice of thy wife, and have eaten of the tree, of which I commanded thee, saying, thou shalt not eat of it. And also, and thistles shall it bring forth to thee, and thou shalt eat the herb of the field, and in the sweat of thy face thou shalt eat bread, till ye return to the ground. For out of it wast thou taken, for dust thou art, and unto dust thou shalt return. Thanks be to God.
Thanks. Next carol, Little Tower of Bethlehem, is number seven.
Second lesson is from Genesis chapter 22. God promises to faithful Abraham that in his seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed. And the angel of the Lord called unto Abraham out of heaven the second time and said, by myself have I sworn, saith the Lord. For because thou hast done this, think, and thou hast not withheld thy son, thine only son, that in blessing I will bless thee. And in multiplying, I will multiply thy seed as the stars of the heaven, and as the sand which is upon the seashore. And thy seed shall possess the gate of his enemies. And in thy seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed, because thou hast obeyed my voice. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Next carol is number 3.
Number 3. prophet foretells the coming of the Saviour. The people that walked in darkness have seen a great light. They that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them hath the light shined. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace there shall be no end, upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom, to order it and to establish it, with judgment and with justice, from henceforth even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our next carol is number 16. It came up on a midnight clear, number 16.
Thank you. The angel Gabriel salutes the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. Luke 1. And in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city of Galilee, named Nazareth, to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came in unto her and said, Hail, thou that art highly favoured, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favour with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David, and he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end. Then said Mary unto the angel, How shall this be, seeing I know not a man? And the angel answered and said unto her, The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that holy thing which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God. And Mary said, Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it unto me according to thy word. And the angel departed from her. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Next carol is number 8. As with gladness then of old. But although it says a collection take, we're not actually going to take a collection in the service. But there are collection plates at the back of the church, which you might like to leave a contribution on the desk at the back of the church. Carol number 8. As with gladness then of old.
This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
seventh lesson from St. Luke, chapter 2. The shepherds go to the manger. And they were in the same country, shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were sore afraid. The angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Saviour, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly they were with the angel. There was a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem, and see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord hath made known to us. And they came with haste, and found Mary and Joseph, and the babe lying in a manger. This is the word of the Lord.
Next carol is number 2. Angels from the realms of glory. Carol number 2.
He demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet, And thou, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are not the least among the princes of Judah. For out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people Israel. Then Herod, when he had privily called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, Go and search diligently for the young child, and when you have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also. When they had heard the king, they departed, and lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold, and frankincense, and myrrh. And being warned of God in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed into their own country another way. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. The same came for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, who were born, not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh, and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. This is the Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
God, who makest us glad with the yearly remembrance of the birth of thy only Son, Jesus Christ. Grant that as we joyfully receive him for our Redeemer, so we may with sure confidence behold him when he shall come to be our Judge, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end. Amen. And now may he who by his incarnation gathered into one things earthly and heavenly, grant you the fullness of inward peace and goodwill, the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon you, and with all whom you hold this day in your heart, and remain with you always. Amen. Thank you very much, everyone, for sharing in our carol service this afternoon. I do hope you've enjoyed it. If you haven't already received a card, a Christmas card from the two churches, there are a supply of those at the back, red cards with details of all the Christmas services over the two churches over the Christmas period. So hope you'll be able to join us another time. But in the meantime, wish you all a very happy and peaceful and joyful Christmas and a peaceful and prosperous New Year. Our final carol is number five, Hark How the Angels Sing.
Peace, to love and to serve the Lord.
In the name.